all I want you to do is just listen to the video with an open mind and know that it was done between Luke and I because we love all of you.
This is Luke Harbur interviewing the Granny Nell Bowen on February 20th, is that right? 2023? And I'm really excited to do this with you, Granny. Thank you.
I am excited. We've wanted to do this for a long time.
I'm just really happy that we're finally getting around to it.
I know. So here we are.
Here we are. Are you ready for your wonderful questions that I have listed for you today? Tell me about what it was like growing up on a farm near Jamesville, North Carolina.
It was wonderful. I had six siblings, my mom and my dad.
Tell me about your parents.
My parents were wonderful. They were hard-working people.
It was skinny mama and fat daddy.
Right.
Right? So skinny mama, I want you to describe her in three adjectives.
She was very attractive.
And it sounds like she was very cleanly.
Yeah, she was.
Give me one more word to describe skinny mama. One more descriptive
word. She was very friendly.
Friendly. That's wonderful. Now give me three words to describe fat daddy.
He was a hard worker. He was very kind. He was a gentleman.
He was a gentleman. Okay. That's a good word. What advice would you give to your children right now with them being in their 60s?
The advice that I gave them came way before now.
Great. What was that advice?
Well, I wanted them to take their school or the situation that they were in and build it like it was a community.
So from what I'm hearing and what you're sharing with me, you should stay involved in your community, whether you are young or old.
That's
being
right.
Involved in your community is important because it just helps you grow as a person.
It starts,
and that's the advice you give your children.
It starts in school.
What do people know you for?
I was probably known in the community for someone to call.
So you'd say you were known for your fudge and cooking, being someone to call, and getting things done.
Yep.
And what was the top price that your fudge was sold for?
6.5 pounds was sold for $55,000.
Tell me about what it's been like to be a grandmother.
When I was in high school, I never really thought about grandparents until on Friday night we'd all be saying goodbye. What are you doing tomorrow? Is it maybe Easter weekend? I'm going to my grandmother's. And I'm going to spend the night. One night I was by myself and I thought, I bet they're at their grandmother's. And I said, you know what? If I ever get to be a grandmother, I will be the best grandmother in the world. And here I had four grandsons.
Yes.
And I said, I'm going to be the best grandmother ever.
And I will be damned if that has not been fact. To anyone who watches this video or listens to this audio, Granny and I both want you to know that we've been wanting to capture our relationship and this history of our family for a long time. And you're looking and listening to two people that are different from each other. But when we say that everything we talk about comes from a place of love and understanding, we hope that all people listening can know, no matter how different someone is from you, you can always find a way to love them.
That's good.
Pretty good?
Thank you, Luke. Say thanks, Lukey.
Thank you, Miss Granny Nell Bowen.